Hey folks, Dr. Bob McCauley, all these supplements that I take to start my day off, coming up. One of the most commonly asked questions I get is, you know, what do you do in the morning? How do you start your day? Well, how I start my day, of course, is with a big tall glass of alkaline ionized water. I've mentioned that many, many times to you. It's exactly what I do. I get up and I drink a big glass just like this, and then I follow it up with another one. I go sit down, whatever I'm going to do. Always start the day with a prayer, of course. But the first thing I put into my body is water, and I drink a lot of it. Never more than about 1 liter, just like that, 1 liter, 1/4 an hour. I don't really eat anything of any substance at all until I've drank at least a liter of water. And then I never have like a meal or anything until I've had 2 liters of water. But as far as supplements, what I try to do in the morning, more than anything, is concentrate on the brain. Really want to get the brain going. I want to get things into it that are going to feed the brain. I know I'm going to be working and doing a lot of an intense either writing. I do a lot of writing and, you know, or making videos like this or whatever. I got to think a lot. And, you know, probably I'm going to tell you 85% of your energy really is used up in the brain, and the rest is what we do physically. So physical activity is one thing, but mental activity is extremely draining. That's why you can sit in your house all day, never do anything, but you got to study or you got to read books. And it's just incredibly, you know, draining. You feel drained at the end of the day. You're so tired. It's because of that mental exhaustion. So I'm going to feed the brain when I wake up. This all happens within the first hour of waking. One of the first things I do, of course, I take liquid angstrom platinum. Platinum's great for the production of DNA. It builds the immune system. A lot of people say platinum. I never heard of that being, you know, one of the essential minerals or something we need. Say the same thing about gold. It's not on the list. Well, gold is great for sleep. I take it in the evening, but I take platinum in the morning because it really helps with many mental acuity, mental focus, concentration. It's really a brain mineral, and it's meant to be taken for alertness, that kind of stuff. So I take it first thing in the morning. The next one I take is magnesium threonate, or magtine as it's generally called, magnesium threonate. Magnesium threonate is magnesium with an amino acid attached to it, L-threonate. And what that amino acid does is it allows it to be taken into the body very efficiently. That's why I always say, tell people, make sure everything you eat has, you're taking with a little bit of protein. You want some amino acids because that really helps assimilate that into the body very efficiently. Well, magnesium threonate is the only kind of magnesium that is known to cross the brain-blood barrier and actually get into the brain. I've mentioned this in several videos. Everybody who's been autopsied of Alzheimer's has no magnesium. They took very smart monkeys, very stupid monkeys. They autopsied them. The smart monkey had a ton of magnesium. The stupid monkey, no magnesium at all. So the onset of Alzheimer's and these other dementia-related diseases definitely is linked to, it's maybe not exclusively, you know, no one knows for sure. You always want to feed the brain, that's why, is to magnesium deficiency. There's no doubt about that. It'll help you sleep through the night. It reduces fear memory or phobias, and it increases good memory. So you tend to have a tendency to remember the good memories. I take some every night before I go to bed. It does help you sleep through the night because it's anti-anxiety. It's not really sleep regulation. And then it's one of the first things I take every single morning. I take about a gram. Okay, that's a small amount in your hand, or you about an eighth of a teaspoon. And you want to take about 2 to 3 grams every single day. It's nice. No taste. Very little bit of taste. Water soluble. Just disappears in a couple minutes. I take it down. Magnesium threonate. Another one I take every single morning, virtually every morning, is an herb called bacopa. Some people call it Brahmi. Brahmi comes from like Brahma, you know, very high, you know, spiritual. It's called a spiritual herb in India. And bacopa, you extract something out of it called bacticillic acid or bactisides. And they're incredible for the brain. They're great for concentration. I used to give some to my son. I'd give him one of these every single morning before you go to school. And he says, you know, if he missed any of those days, he says, boy, I couldn't concentrate as well in school. So amazing for focus and concentration, bacopa, or some people call it Brahmi. but I call it Bacopa, but I take it every single day, and I do it first thing in the morning, again, trying to get that brain going. Another one I take first thing in the morning, Rhodiola. Rhodiola is great for focus and concentration. It is really, it's called the golden root. You know, it's an immune building. It improves libido. It's good for weight loss. But really, the central focus, as far as I'm concerned, it is a nervine, or, you know, what we call an herbal extract, a nervine. It's meant for the nerves. It's really focus and concentration. Again, you know, all these I'm telling you about, they're all herbal extracts. Like this is a Bacopa, 53% herbal extract. So we're extracting the bactisolic acid. And here it's the rosevins that we extract in here. So you really want to get that. If you just take these in powder form, it's really hard to get enough of it to do much for you. But when you extract and concentrate, I only take one or two capsules of this in the morning and then I'm done. I like Rhodiola. I take it every single morning. Next one I take is Focus 500. And the active ingredient, the key ingredient in here is something called phosphatidylserine. Or for short, PS. People call it PS all the time because they can't pronounce phosphatidylserine apparently. But it's got this, the serine part. That's you know, that's an amino acid. So phosphatidylserine is kind of a derivative of that. How they get, they've taken the phosphate and the serine and put it together. Really great for the brain. Really feeds it extremely well. That is the key ingredient. I've given PS or phosphatidylserine to people with extreme ADD. Attention deficit disorder, and you know, it's like suddenly they're much improved. I don't want to say they're perfect or anything. We cured anything because it's very difficult, but they're able to concentrate a lot better. It's the PS phosphatidylserine that does it. This happens to be again a 50% extract. Everything I use in here are extracts. The Bacopa is an extract. You need to get it concentrated. Same with the Rhodiola. Concentrate it down. You really want to extract it to get those active ingredients in there, because otherwise, if you're just trying to take the powders, you really got to take a huge amount of it to make any kind of a difference. And that's the beauty of these extracts. And honestly, folks, most of these, like the Bacopa, I mean, this is the worst tasting thing you've ever put in your mouth. It's just awful. Rhodiola is not nearly as bad. But most of these things are really pretty terrible. So we put them in capsules, make it easy for people. But you've got a bunch of amino acids, all meant for the brain, of course. You have got essential fatty acids meant to feed the brain, DHA, ALA, alpha-linolenic acid, GLA, gamma-linolenic acid, and then these herbal extracts. So that's another one that I take for concentration, again, trying to get that brain going first thing in the morning. Next one on my list, of course, is Blues Booster. That's our other product, and it's for, you know, the blues or for depression or whatever you want to call it. I always say, you know, a lot of people have depression. They're kind of embarrassed by it. They don't want to talk about it or anything. You know, they think it's this terrible disease, and why am I depressed? Well, if you're clinically depressed, as they call it, you know, meaning there's no reason why you're depressed. Like if somebody died in your family, okay, hey, you're depressed. You should be depressed. But if you're just depressed all the time, you don't know why. Well, usually that serotonin level is real low in your brain. And what you want for that is 5-HTP. So the main ingredient is 5-HTP, which is a very concentrated active form of tryptophan. And that feeds the brain amazingly well and really helps boost the serotonin levels. There's other brain herbs that I do take. For instance, Makuna will do that, but not as good first thing in the morning. I think the Makuna, I take it right before I go to bed, but I do the Blues Booster because, again, a nice collection of amino acids, essential fatty acids, and some herbal extracts in here. But it's the 5-HTP that is really the key ingredient in this. And I've had some people with really severe depression take this and say, wow, you know, I really felt a lot better with this. So, again, we're not here to make any claims we can cure anything because, you know, usually your diet has a lot to do with it. But if you really want to, you know, get that thing going in the morning called the brain so you can think throughout the day, make sure it's energized, these are the things I do to feed it. I got one more that I want to tell you about, but it really doesn't have anything to do with the brain, but I take it every day. Now this one, I actually take a couple more here. I do take a little spirulina and chlorella. I always start my day with that. Not a huge amount, maybe just maybe 3 or 4 grams. You know, I'm not going to usually eat anything too much in the morning, but I might take a few grams of that. I'm going to get into another video about all the energy products I take. and why I take them and when I take them, so I got energy throughout the day. But the one thing I do take every morning, just to touch upon it, is maca. Maca is a root. This is just maca powder. I don't do the extract myself. It balances your hormones. It is really just absolutely amazing stuff. It really is one of the best, you know, foods. I'm just going to call this a food. It's a root, another one of the great roots. I'm always talking about roots. Rhodiola comes from a root, as an example as well. But the maca is just this amazing root. It's found, you know, the best stuff comes out of South America, grown very high altitudes. Balances the hormone, but gives you this all-day energy. So we'll just use that as a crossover. Those are all the products I use to feed my brain in the morning, and then I take the maca for energy, and we'll get into all those other ones at another time. This is how I get my day started, folks. This is it. Water, and then start getting the brain going, because you got a lot to do during the day, and I know you guys do as well. Dr. Bob McCauley, see you next time. Visit us at watershed.net.